Hi, I'm Ian Gonsenhauser, Chief Quality and Patient Safety Officer at the Ohio State University Wexner Medical Center. Today, we're going to talk about some of the truths and some of the untruths about personal protective equipment, or PPE. Number one, there's a lot of talk that coronavirus may be spread via airborne transmission, or that it's in the air that we breathe. This isn't what we believe to be the case at this point. We're working on assumptions and science and data that suggest that coronavirus is spread via droplets, meaning it's in the respiratory droplets that are expelled when you sneeze or cough. Number two, there are some claims that an N95 mask is necessary in all situations. We really don't believe that to be the case at this point. There are certain circumstances where an N95 mask is critical. Those circumstances include very close clinical interactions and particularly clinical interactions that produce aerosols, things like adding a breathing tube in the treatment of a patient or doing surgery on the lung. In other situations, a typical isolation mask is likely all that's necessary, if a mask is necessary at all. I've received some comments through social media and I've read in the press that there are concerns that hospitals don't want people wearing masks or other PPE. This is simply not true. Every member of our staff, every visitor to our hospital, is a part of the mission to keep our patients and our staff members safe and healthy. We want everybody wearing appropriate PPE where it's necessary. That means isolation masks where they can be helpful, N95 masks where they can be helpful, and no mask where they aren't required. We have to be very cautious that we protect our supply of masks so that we have them when they're needed and where they're needed, and we can keep everybody safe. So for those of you staying home to stay safe, pay attention to the CDC guideline and remember that wearing a cloth mask may help those who are unaware that they are carrying the virus from spreading it in the community. This is particularly important when social distancing is difficult to achieve in situations like a busy grocery store or in public transportation. Now remember, the most important thing that we can all be doing is appropriate hand hygiene, cough etiquette, and maintaining our social distance. Thank you.